In this video, we will discuss about interface. So, what do you mean by interface? So, using the keyword interface, you can fully abstract interface from its implementation. That is, using interface, you can specify what a class must do. So, one class can implement any number of interfaces. So, here is the definition of interface. An interface defined much like a class. This is simplified general form of interface. So, an interface is defined is a simplified general form of interface, and here is you can write it as this interface name, return type method name 1 parameter list, and return type method name 2 parameter. So type final var name and type final this. So this is a structure of interface. So here is an example of interface definition. Let's see with this example. So this is name interface callback. So let's see here. Callback. It's opening now. So when no SS modifier is included, then default SS results and the interface is only available to other members of the package in which it is declared. So taking time, so meanwhile callback.java, I think it's open here. So time, that is callback. So callback, here is an example of interface definition. It declares a simple interface that contains one method called callback. Here is a package name and so interface callback, void callback in, or here is a parameter. You can write here parameter. Okay, so now the next topic is implementing interfaces. So how we can implement interface? Oh, this slide is not. With the NetBeans, it's going to slow. So, assessing implementation through interface references. Once an interface has been defined, one or more classes can implement that interface. To implement an interface, include the implements clause in a class definition, then create the method required by the interface. The general form of a class that includes the implement clause looks like this. Looks like this: class, class name, extend superclass, implements interface, and class body. So if a class implements more than one interface, then the interfaces are separated with the comma. If a class implements two interfaces that declare the same method, then the same method will be used by the client of either interface. So the methods that implement an interface must be declared public. Also, the type signature of the implementing method must match exactly the type signature specified in the interface definition. So here is a small example class that implements the callback interface shown earlier. So it is a class, client implements callback. So let's see with a practical example. Class client. So class client implements callback, public void callback int, here is a p, and this. So you can see this. So notice that the callback is declared using the public ss specifier or modifier. When you implement an interface method, it must be declared as public. It is both permissible and common for classes that implement interfaces to define additional member of their own. For example, the following version of client implements callback and adds the method non-iFaceMap. So if we can add this. So assessing implementation through interface references. So let's go to the next topic. This is done now. So class test iFace public static void main. Here it is. So let's see with the practical example. Class test iFace. This one. So package Shiva Foundation and the test class iFace. So you can run it. Let's go to the another topic. Here is polymorphic power of search reference. So the notice that the variable C is declared to be the interface type callback, yet it was assigned an instance of client. Although C can be used to assess the callback method, it cannot assess any other members of the client class. An interface reference variable has knowledge only of the methods declared by its interface declaration. Thus, C could not be used to assess non-iFace method since it is defined by the client but not callback. While the preceding example shows mechanically how an interface reference variable can assess an implementation object, so it does not demonstrate the polymorphic power of such reference. To sample this usage, first create the second implementation of callback shown here. So here is another implementation of callback. The class another client implements callback. So let's see here, another client. So here is public class, another client implements callback. So implements is a keyword used in interface. Public void callback in P, and this another version of callback P. So now try the following class test face I. So you can check it. So here is the output of this program. Callback call with 42. Another version of callback p squared is 176. So as you can see, the version of callback that is call is determined by the type of object that C refers to at runtime. While this is very simple example, you will see another more practical one shortly. So let's go here. So this is covered now. So let's go to partial implementation. So if a class includes an interface but does not fully implement the method required by that interface, then that class must be declared abstract. For example, abstract class incomplete implements callback. So let's see with the example app incomplete. Abstract class incomplete implements callback. Here is int ab void show system.prelim. So this is a program. So you can see here. Partial implementation of interface. So here the class incomplete does not implement callback and must be declared as abstract. So any class that inherits incomplete must implement callback or be declared as abstract itself. So let's go to another topic now. Nested interface. So an interface can be declared a member of a class or another interface or nested interface. A nested interface can be declared as public, private, and protected. So let's see with the example nested interface. So class A. So let's see the example. So here it is, class A1 public class interface nested if. So this is the example of nested interface. So notice that A defines a member interface called nested if, and it is declared as public. Next, B implements the nested interface by specifying. So implement A dot nested if. Notice that the name is fully qualified by the enclosing class names. Inside the main method, and a nested if reference called nif is created, and it is assigned a reference to a B object. Because B implements a nested if, this is legal. So next is applying interfaces. So understand the power of interfaces. Let's look at a more practical example. In earlier chapter, you developed a class called stack. So in our tutorial 18, we developed a class implement stack. For example, the stack can be of field fixed size, or it can be growable. A stack can also be held in array. Linked list stack remains the same. So that is the method push pop. Define the interface to the stack independently of the details of implementation, because the interface to a stack is separate from its implementation. So it is easy to define a stack interface, leaving it to each implementation to define specifies. So let's look at two examples. First, here is the interface that defines an integer stack. Put this in a file called intstack.java. So this interface will be used by both stack implementation. So interface int stack. So let's go to the example. Here it is. So here integer stack interface int stack void push int item and int pop. So with this, here we define the stack interface, and with this line we are storing an item, and in pop we are retrieving an item. So follow program creates a class call, and then go to the, we are going to the next new program, fix stack. The implement six length version of an integer stack. So let's go to the fix stack. So you can see here, so class fix stack implements in stack. Here is ss modifier and this. So you can better understand with this example. So this is an example of applying interfaces. So let's go to the another example of die of following another implementation in stack. That case a dynamic stack by use of the same interface definition. In this implementation, each stack is constructed with an initial length. If this initial length is exceeded, then the stack is increased in size. So each time more room is needed, the size of the stack is doubled. So here it is. So class DynStack implements InStack. So here is a dynamic stack. This is the example of dynamic stack. So then the class uses both fixed stack and dynamic stack implementation. So it does so through an interface reference. This means that calls to push and pop are resolved at runtime rather than at compile. So now we will see the example of create an interface variable and assess stacks through. So if test 3. So this is example. Here public static void main string, and this is the test of these. So you can see here. So in this program, MyStack is a reference to the InStack interface. Thus, when it refers to DS, it uses the version of push and pop defined by DynStack implementation. When it refers to FS, it uses version of push pop defined by fixed stack. As explained, these determinations are made runtime. Assessing multiple implementation of an interface through an interface reference variable is the most powerful way that the Java achieves runtime polymorphism. So our next topic is variables in interface. Variables in interface. So let's see the example of it. Shared constants. You can use interfaces to import shared constants into multiple classes by simply declaring an interface that contains variables that are initialized to the desired value. When you include the interface in a class, that is when you implement the interface, all of those to create a large number of hash defined constants or constant declaration. If an interface contains no methods, then any class that includes such an interface doesn't actually implement anything. It is as if that class were importing the constant field into the class namespace as final. The next example uses this technique to implement an automated decision maker. So let's go with this program. So here we are importing. And then this is shared constant interface. These are data type. And if else, then we are using here switch. And public static void. So this is the example of variables in interfaces. So notice that this program makes use of one of the Java standard classes, random. So this class provides pseudo random number. It contains several methods that allow you to obtain random number in the form required by your program. So in this example, the method nextTuple is used. It returns random number in the range 0.0 to 1.0. In this example program, the two classes question and ask me both implement the shared constant interface, where no, yes, maybe, soon, later, and never be defined. So inside each class, the code refers to those constants as if each class had defined or inherited from them directly. So here is the output of the sample run program of this is later, soon, no, or yes. So this, the technique of using an interface to define shared constant as just described is a confirmation. It is described here for completeness. Now interfaces can be extended. One interface can inherit another by use of keyword extend. So syntax is the same as for inheriting classes. When a class implements an interface that inherits another interface, it must provide implementation for all methods required by the interface inheritance chain. Following is the example. One interface can extend another. So let's see. So one interface can extend another. Here is the interface A, then interface B1. So A2 extends, B1 extends A2. So this is the example of interface can be extended. So as an experiment, you might want to try removing the implementation of method 1 in my class, and this will cause a compile time error. As stated earlier, any class that implements an interface must implement all methods required by that interface, including any that inherited from other interfaces. So we covered almost all topics. So default interface methods. As explained earlier, prior to JDK 8, an interface could not define any implementation whatsoever. This means that for all previous versions of Java, the methods specified by an interface were abstract and containing no body. This is a traditional form of interface, and changed this by adding a new capability of two interface called default method. Default method lets you define a default implementation for an interface method. In other words, by use of default method, it is now possible for an interface method to provide a body rather than being abstract. During the development, the default method was also referred to as an extension method, and you will likely to see both terms used. Primary motivation for default method was to provide means by which interfaces could be explained without breaking existing code. Then multiple inheritance issues. Multiple inheritance issues. Class can maintain state information specially through the use of instance variation, but an interface cannot. Thus, to limited extent, default method do support multiple inheritance of behavior. As you might guess, in such a situation, it is possible that a name conflict will occur. For example, assume that two interfaces called alpha and beta are implementing by a class called my class. What happens if both alpha beta provide a method called reset, for which both declare a default implementation is the version of alpha on the version of beta used by my class? Or consider a situation in which beta extend alpha. Which version of the default method is used? Or what if my class provides its own implementation of the method? To handle these and other simple types of situations, Java defines a set of rules that resolve such conflicts. First, in all cases, a class implementation takes priority over interface default implementation. Thus, if my class provides an override of the reset default method, so my class version is used. This is the case even if my class implements both alpha and beta in this case. Both defaults are overridden by my class implementation. Second, in cases a class implements two interfaces that both have the same default method, but the class does not provide right that method, then error will result. Continuing with example, if my class implements both alpha and beta but does not override reset, then an error will occur. In cases in which one interface inherits another, both defining a common default method, the inherited interface version of the method takes precedence. Therefore, continuing the example, if beta extends alpha, then beta version of reset will be used. So using a new form of super, its general form is shown here. Interface name super method, super dot method name. For example, if beta wants to refer to alpha, default for reset, can use this statement. So alpha dot super reset. Use of static method in an interface. So interface name static method. So let's see with the example. So here is the example. JDK 8 added another new capability to interface, the ability to define one or more static methods. Like static method in a class, static method defined by an interface can be called independently of any object. Thus, no implementation of the interface is necessary and no instance of interface is required. In order to call a static method, instead a static method is called by specifying the interface name, followed by a period, followed by the method name. Here the general form. General form is here. This is the general form. Interface name, static method name. So notice that this is similar to the way that the static method in a class calls. So the following shows an example of static method in interface by adding one to my if shown in the previous section, the static method get default number returns 0. So public interface, this is a normal interface method declaration. It does not define default implementation. So here is a int get number, default string get string. This is the example of using static method in an interface. So the get default number method can be called as shown here. If def num is equal to my if get default number is mentioned, no implementation or instance my if is required to call get default because it is static. One last point, static interface method are not enacted by either an implementing class or sub interface. Final thoughts on final packages and interfaces. Although the example we have included in this video do not make frequent use of packages or interfaces, both of these tools are an important part of Java environment. Virtually all real program that you write in Java will be contained within packages. A number will probably implement interfaces as well. It is important, therefore, that you can be comfortable with their usage. So, in our next video, we will